she's thinking about the way he won her affection. She was so cynical about love, cause she didn't wanna be heartbroken again.
Let's create another singer. Listen to these words that I'm enraged. Oh Lord, I can't believe my faith. These people got. And you know what? I'm sorry again. I'm gonna start again. I'm not a rapper either. You see, that's the problem. The shade of my skin funnels your expectations of me. A rapper, a singer, a basketball player. Sway my lyrical inclinations, determining how I express, the triggers and traumas of my existence. I mean, I feel, I know myself. But in front of you, everything gets twisted. I say this, but I'm aware of my own complicity in this whole drama. For I allow your oppression of me. The autopsy of my art reveals a bastard child. One that has been molded in spite of you. To spite you. You're really messing with me. We suffocate under the prisons of the universe's structures. Our voices torn, raped, and distorted beyond recognition. Even before I pronounce these words, or put ink to paper or stroke to keyboard, I've been trapped both by your language and my own lineage. How do I write? How do I speak of my blackness, of my Africanness, without you already preceding me, without your judgments, without your stereotypes preceding me? But as I say, I'm as much my own Jada as you are mine. The only difference between you and I is that you're employed and paid for your job. I can see in your eyes, you weren't expecting such provocative words. Well, I guess you're gonna have to put up with it because I'm on the stage and now you have to listen to me. Understand this. Understand that we're at war against one another. Our mutual myopias grow with each passing encounters. Each side increasingly resolved and resolute in our respective trenches. But as I say, there is a difference between you and I, for you alone enjoy the spoils of war. And so we're gathered here today to share in the blame, to confess that we are accomplices to an existential crime. But there's a way out, a salvation, a parachute from this calamitous fall that has bred so many catastrophic and constrained words. We must recognize that we are enriched by one another. We must understand that the work of art is communicating without expectation, of speaking and writing without prisms. We must be. We must be ourselves. We must be.
Thank you. I'll go to the day tomorrow. I was first time in Berlin. I remember it was the European Championships on at the time, and something really peculiar happened. I was sat and I was watching the England game, and England scored a goal, and I cheered. Now this is a strange thing to have happened, because I remember growing up under Nigerian parents, and it kind of trained me to kind of hate everything English. I remember, it's very strange, that I think I grew up supporting whenever the English cricket team played, I'd support whoever they were playing, the English football team, I'd support whoever they were playing. And so it was such a weird thing then, that as I'm traveling around Europe, then I cheer, really at the age of 26, I cheer an England goal. It's the first time that ever happened. Yeah, I don't know. I think when you're born to Nigerian parents, you're second generation immigrant. Yeah, things are a bit weird. Identity, where you're from, where you be, what is home. And this is a poem about that. It's called Cashews. Cashew, 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 cashew. I got an archipelago of femininity, got them cashews. I don't mean to be deliberately obtuse, I've been told I do that. It's just London done raised me, so I gotta give it back. One condition, unconditionally, I've been riding through the ends with my wolves, backpack on my back, back to the pack, step back, back to the pack, seat driving. Mush, no license, so hush. lurking, giving sermons out to sinners. Don't I know them well? A three-pronged thirst, us pointing skyward, northwestern investment, standing, straddling London bridges, primary eyes shut with these eyes open, sesame secrets, nuh-uh, keys to the city, uh-huh, give me that work. Old factory started up, so I opened up my nose, far as it would go, and swallow London whole and all its lurid darkness, nasty my car right to the heart of it. I think it worked. You know it also, I try to recycle all my eyes, baptize the eyes that died in a waiting room. Immer noch liminal, still in limbo, though, so the ritual renew plasma, tabula rasa, mi casa su casa, so easy. 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 Go home. Don't know really what that means. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
That's much better. So first things first, I'm an entrepreneur. So if you've got dreadlocks, if you've got a friend with dreadlocks, I can fix your hair just like the way mine is. Yeah. Then secondly, I've got my chapbook with me. So if you like what I do, you can easily buy a book or pay the price of two for just one book. It's allowed. Lastly, Berlin has been calling me, so soon I'm just gonna be a Berliner. So yeah. I want to be a lot of things in your life, like that wristwatch. The digital one. It better be smart, because I wanted to record each and every minute that we spent together. Every step that you take with me will be recorded. I'll be the first thing that you put on the very minute you wake up, because each minute, each second is important to be recorded in. And I'll be the last thing you take off before you go to bed. You see, I want to be a lot of things in your life. Like that cup of coffee in the morning. When you brew me, the aroma as you take a shower should linger around the house and the kitchen. And when you sip me slowly, damn, this coffee is damn too good. So I want the last sip to stay. That aftertaste, the aftertaste which is really good. I want to be that last sip of your coffee. You see, I want to be that red glass, that glass of red wine, so that when you smell me, you see, you already know what I want to be, right? See, I want to be a lot of things in your life. Your bed, the one that you come back home to when your day is finished and when you're ready to retire, you sleep yourself into me, your body on mine, and you relax. And you know, this is what it means to be at home. I want to be your New Balance trainers, to be with you in each jog that you take each morning. You see, what I've discovered with the trainers is you make them fit in each occasion. So be at a birthday party, at the office, when you're running, all these places, I want to be there with you. You see, I want to be a lot of things in your life, like that notebook of yours. You always keep it with you. So between trains, trams, bus stops, rides, you take notes. So I want to be that ink that lingers, that stays, that dots, paints the pages of your notebook. You see, I want to be a lot of things in your life, like your cell phone, you know. It records everything, your diary is in there, all your precious memories are engraved in there. See, I want to be that tattoo on your right arm, so that when you greet the world, they will know that it is me that is in your life, and it will show. So when you wear your vest, your t-shirts, and when you tuck up your sleeves, it will be me that they will see. You see, I want to be a lot of things in your life, but right now I'm good with that, because I'm already a lot of things in your life.
Because I just said that I'm gonna perform a German poem.
because we're in Germany. No, just joking. sorry, I don't know why I'm being so sarcastic today. Okay, it's called Ich küsse die Blätter deiner Träume. Translated, it means I kiss the leaves of your dreams. Ich küsse die Blätter deiner Träume. Ich fürchte um dein Ich dich nicht, sieh die Blätter an und seufze. Ich küsse die Ringe deiner Augen, ich fürchte mich, erblinde nicht, du Elend meines Ich-Ich-Ichs, lass die Winde dich berauben. Ich küsse die Feder deiner Flügel, sie überfallen mich, ich fürchte mich, sie wollen den Boden nicht berühren, verlieren das Gleichgewicht. Wir fürchten uns, ich küsse uns, du riechst an dein Vergissmeinnicht, wir fliehen ins Almanistan und trinken zu viel Elmatschai, ein Hoch auf dein Ich dich nie. Ich küsse die Blätter deiner Träume. Ich fürchte um dein Ich dich mich, sieh die Blätter an und seufze. Ich küsse die Falten deiner Hände, ich fürchte um mein Ich-Du-Dasein, verbrenne sie, das wollte ich nicht. Ich küsse die Strähnen deiner Haare, sie kräuseln sich, das willst du nicht, sie symbolisieren den Kreislauf der Galaxie. Beängstigend für andere, befürchte ich. Ich fürchte mich vor dunklen und vor hellen Wegen, vor dem Falschen, dem Richtig, vor dem Undenkbaren, nach meinem Tod. Rückkehren ins verpasste Leben, Hass auf den Bass, Hass auf den Pass ausschalten, weil die Babys bunte Tränen malten. Dankeschön. Ṣùgbọ́n ẹ bá mi kọ sílẹ̀ wípé mo ti rí o. Ilé mi dàrú, ọ̀tá mi ti sá lọ, ọmọdé ń bọ̀, kò sí nǹkan kan mọ́. Ṣùgbọ́n ẹ bá mi kọ sílẹ̀ wípé mo ti rí gbogbo játijáti láyé pẹ̀lú jaéjaé tí wọ́n wí, èmi nìkan mo ti rí ẹ̀jẹ̀ lójú mi. Omi láti fojú mi, ó ti tán ẹ̀jẹ̀ lójú mi. Ilé mi dàrú, àwọn ọ̀rẹ́ mi ó ti sá lọ, ọmọdé ń bọ̀, kò sí nǹkan kan mọ́. Ojú tí mi, níbo ni ayé mi lọ, jọ̀wọ́ máa fi mi sílẹ̀ náà. Mo ti rí ìfẹ́ tó ń kọjá báyìí, ìkú tó ń wá mi káàkiri wà láàyè. Mo ti rí ẹ̀kọ́ sílẹ̀, ilé mi dàrú, ọkọ mi ti sá lọ, ọmọdé ń bọ̀, kò sí nǹkan kan mọ́. Ẹ̀yẹ ẹfẹ́ rí mi, labalábá wọn kórè orí orú mi, omi lójú mi, ọwọ́ láti fojú mi ò ní omi lójú mi. Ẹ̀kọ́ sílẹ̀, ọ̀la wọn máa bèèrè àlàáfíà ọkọ mi. Òtún ọ̀la wọn máa bèèrè, wọn máa bẹ̀rẹ̀ láti pè mí ajé ayọ̀. Ilé mi dàrú, mi ò ní sá lọ, ọmọdé ń bọ̀, mi ò ní ké mọ́, torí mo ti rí ayọ̀ mi, àdùn, ogun, òṣùn, bóòsùn, máa padà sílé, títí láyé. Thank you.
Different instances. And I do find humans among the most fascinating creatures on the planet, to be honest. Very unnecessarily complicated, with not too much complexity. So someday I was thinking about this, and this poem came to me. It's about the differences that we have, the differences, the biases we all have that form our little myopic views on the world. So, here we go. I said, there is no normal or abnormal. There is no sane or insane. There is no good or bad. There is no wrong or right. There is no left. There is no right. There is no front. There is no back. There is nothing. All we have is perspective. Thank you.
Hope you enjoy it. Shosholoza Ngulele Zontaba Stimela Sipume South Africa When uyabaleka Ngulele Zontaba Stimela Sipume South Africa Shosholoza mama Yeah Ngulele Zontaba Stimela Sipume South Africa Whoop, whoop. There is a train. There is a train that transports young African men from Namibia, Zambia, Angola, Botswana, Lesotho, Mozambique. Shook, 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 shook. Whoop, whoop. There is a train. This train separates these men with melanin skin from their sons and daughters, wives and uncles, never to be seen again. Shook, 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 shook. Whoop, whoop. This train arrives in Johannesburg, the city of gold. 30 to 40 of these men squeezed like sardines in barren barracks, eating off of metal plates whilst cursing the cruelty of their fate. The cold of colonialism is in their bones. Shook, 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 shook. Whoop, whoop. These men dig and dig and dig. Deep, deep, deep into the hinterlands of African land. They dig and dig and dig for the first world's commodity, gold, a raw mineral of immorality. Shook, 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 shook. Whoop, whoop, Johannesburg, the city of gold. Gold to be worn on European hands and necklaces. Gold, a noose around these men's necks. Stimela, Igoli, whoop, whoop, Johannesburg, the city of gold. Dankeschön.
You meet a new person in a racist place, it's like having a sort of a racial visa. Oh my God, he's black, but is he okay? Can we let him into our conversation? Oh, can we let him into our friendship group? Oh my goodness. Then you present your sort of racial visa, which is either a qualification or it's a funny joke, or you can jump very high, you can dunk a basketball, and you've always got this black visa, and I hate having the black visa, right? So I'm sick of the black visa, and this poem is about having the black visa, and it's called Black Is, and it's very short, and actually the poem itself is shorter than the rant, which I just made up because I'm angry about being black. I'm angry about being boring. Anyway, whatever. The poem is called Black Is. It's very short, and because my rant was so long, I've only got maybe one more poem, but come on, whatever. So this poem's called Black Is, and it's like this, about blackness. Black is. What is black? Black is rap. Black is jazz, tap. Black is Hackney, East London as a habitat. Black is no back chat to your gun and mum, she's a battle axe. Barack Obama is the new black. The old black, back when they sold black, was trapped in the shadow of the gallows. Black is a straitjacket. Black is a lower than average pay packet. But black is not gay.
No, black is not gay.
Black is man. Black is brag, a swagger. Black is baggy jeans, an urban teen with a dagger. Black is twice as long getting through customs. Black is, I don't know what it is about those boys in the corner, but I don't think I trust them. Black is millions of Billie Jeans, single mums with sons whose dads were gone long before their delivery. Black is laughter and anger, Richard Pryor and gangland pistol fire. Black is hardcore, Darfur. Black is a victim. Black is a street corner yelling evangelical Christian. Black is a true story, more compelling than fiction. Black is black and white. Always the extremes, it seems. Either president or menacing. Either a thief or a first-class degree in medicine. But my black? No. My black is grey, with most, if not all, warts on display. My black does not worship God, but all his friends are saints. And my black is not on the Muhammad Ali, Pele, Othello, or Mandela level of melanin. But every single day, my black is a little more genuine. Thank you. Well, thank you. Thank you for listening. This is my final poem. Because my rants were long. Come on, man. Let's be real. My rants were long. So let's be real. The rants were long. So we've got to keep it disciplined because the kickoff is, you know. And France are playing Romania. My black brothers are playing tonight against Romania. I've got to represent. My man Kante's out there. Pogba's out there. Let me get the dab right there. Yeah. Dabbed on stage. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. So this is the last poem. I enjoyed that. I really enjoyed the dab. Like, it was so robotic. I just lowered that. Yeah, it's a robot. Yeah. People don't get the dab. People, like, they do the dab. They're like, guys, I had the teacher the other day, the dab. He was like, he came on stage. He was like, oh, yeah, I'll do the dab. He was in a bar. He was like doing the dab. And he was just like, there was not enough lock in the neck. You have to go. That's what makes it the third movement. Anyway, sorry, just to get into that. Okay, listen. This is the last poem. That's not a poem. That's a rant. It's not really a rant. It's more of a stream of, anyway, whatever. Look, okay, look. This is the last poem. It's called Passport, and I haven't got a passport here today because I probably lose it in my current condition, so I want you to imagine this is a passport, and the poem is about 3 minutes 30, and it goes like this. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you for listening. If you like the books, there's books around, and regardless, either way, thank you for listening to everyone, all the great poets. It's been a joy, and have a great night. So here we go. I have your passport. What more could I ask for? You see, from its few clues, I can soon deduce who you were and how much further in your pursuit I have to go. For it's natural that a son plays catch-up. That's his role. Yes, that's his role. So, Dad, it says here you were born in Uganda. Raised in its northeast in the early 1940s. And it's clear from the cluster of stamps in here that you loved Kenya, Zambia, Tanzania. You loved traveling. You dressed sharp as a javelin. Your handwriting was sleek. Yes, I see comparisons. Even your jackets I wear as well. Those 70s classics they rarely sell. And look. I outgrew you. I 6'2'd you. Touche, you lose at 6'1". As for professions, we've got different ones. I didn't mimic you as a medic. You see, I loathe blood. But you've opened up more wounds than you've ever closed up, sewed up. Since we poets, we bear souls more urgently than new surgeons repair souls. It says here you were born 5 days from Christmas. I used to own your leather band book of scriptures, but to my mother, that's now been restored. since my rapport with the Lord is not as warm as yours. Speaking of mother, seeing as you're her husband, you'd think she'd mention you loads, but she doesn't. I guess she's still upset that you went to war, but when she talks of you, there's an impressive warmth. Your dad was the best man, you can rest assured. He didn't think that the fist was the best resort. The only thing I confess that I'm left to mourn is that he walked in the steps of the less mature. Your passport. Its expiry date reads July 1986, but you haven't needed a visa for ages since. You see, impatiently, you couldn't wait to leave. So you boarded that flight off in late 1983, off to that place where there are no airfares or cares. Your passport. Its number reads 74562. And that is code for forever, Dad, will I miss you. And since you did not ever get to fly the route that you were meant to, I promise that I will claim the entire sky for you.
She was so cynical about love, 'cause she didn't wanna be heartbroken again. He looked her in her eye with sincerity, said he only wanted to protect her, so she took a chance.